Hey, welcome to the review of the recently updated TN36, now called the TN36 2017. Sorry, I'm out of funny intros right now. Someone's like, "Oh, they were supposed to be funny." Oh, okay then. So even though the hair gel guys got to it first, here's my take on the TN36 2017. As you can guess by the imaginatively named TN36 2017, it is an updated for 2017 offering of the TN36 and TN36 UT, which changes up the UI and jacks up the brightness. So Thrunite can try to compete with the new lumen monsters that come out pretty much every damn month now. The new TN36 2017 comes in a brown box with a MCC-4s charger, four protected Hydrian 18650 lithium ion batteries, the light, a holster, some manuals, spare O-rings, a lanyard, and some button cover things. Like the TN36 before it, it's made out of aluminium with type 3 anodizing. It also uses a battery carrier, got a glass lens, and boasts three Cree XHP70 cool white or neutral white emitters. Man, I should have used boasts a while ago. I'm reviewing the cool white version because winter has finally come. Man, I wish that came with a royalty check. Okay, output levels. My estimated figures and the Thrunites are listed on the screen, courtesy of our expensive and well-staffed graphics department. First is Firefly, a very respectable low mode for a light that outputs as much as this one does. Then is Infinite mode, which starts out at 48 lumens and goes all the way up to 5,850 lumens, with many, many small increments in between, so you can find the right amount of brightness for you. When I talk about figures here, I'm referring to my estimations, right? Then Turbo. My measured value is less than a Thrunite's. Remember, my estimates serve as estimates only with some DIY measuring techniques, in case you've forgotten. I made a video about it a while ago, so watch it. Oh, and here is a beam profile shot versus the X7. For those interested people whose main use of flashlights is shining them on their apartment wall and comparing tints. What about the charger? Yeah, what about it? Sorry. The charger is a fairly straightforward universal charger. It charges your nickel metal hydride or NiMh AA, AAA, C's and D's, also, what's NiCads? Does anybody use NiCads anymore? And lithium ion batteries, like this light uses, and LiFe P04 batteries. The display will scroll through the charge time, the voltage, and the rate at which it's charging. You can either select half an amp charging rate or an amp per channel. Just hit the red button. Now it will automatically detect most types of batteries except for the LiFe P04 cells, which a manual explains you have to hit buttons to unlock the cheat functionality of that. So let's do a time lapse here. Starting voltage was 2.9 volts. I charge my lithium ion batteries at 1 amp, and I usually charge my eneloops at half an amp, although you won't see the eneloops here. So I found the charger reads a higher voltage on the ending voltage than it really is. I saw my lithium ion batteries were saying 4.22 volts. I checked them with my multimeter and they read 4.2 or less. Translated, it seems to be a safe charger and you shouldn't worry that its ending voltage is reading a little bit higher, at least in my experience. On the downside, some people want accurate voltage readout. You should have a digital multimeter for that, by the way. My Nikkor D4, which I use all the time and it is plugged in all the time, does kind of the same thing, except it reads a little bit lower. Anyway, that's why I use my BTC3100 charger when I need an accurate voltage readout for tests. When I just need a dumb universal charger, I either use this or my Nikkor. The charger gets warm when charging four batteries at an amp, but never too hot to touch. I read about 115 Fahrenheit or 46 Celsius on the sides and top. Final charging time was a bit over 4 hours. How about that user interface? Thrunite has been putting this new user interface on all of their new models that I've reviewed, which is good. So you're probably familiar with it if you watch my reviews of their lights, but people would complain if I didn't bore everyone with doing it over again for the third time. It operates identically to the headlamp, the TH20, I believe, and the Neutron 2C for 2017. For those that get it and understand it, why don't you go get a beer and come back in like 5 minutes? Okay, have your batteries in. Press and hold from off for Firefly. Firefly is not saved in a mode memory. Okay, how about let's just get right to turbo? It's off or on, just double click to get to turbo. That is also not saved in a mode memory. It shouldn't be, to be honest, since it's so easy to get to. To get to regular brightness levels, a quick press from off gets you there, and a quick press turns it off. So quick presses turn it on and off. Press and hold in regular brightness levels when you're in them to go up and down the infinite scale. I mean, it's not really infinite, but the brightness steps are spaced so closely together, you probably can't tell the difference. As you press and hold, it goes up the brightness scale, flashes, then slowly goes back down, flashes and goes back up, flashes, you get the idea. If you were to release it at any time and press and hold it again, it goes the opposite way that you were going, so if you pass up that perfect brightness, you can always go back to it pretty easy. It saves any level you were in the infinite brightness scale to mode memory. Cool. Okay, and for that guy who was waiting around to see how to get to strobe, you have to be in turbo, so double click to get there. Then a second double click gets to tactical strobe. So tactical, go chug a beer. Or two. The light employs an electronic switch. As with any lights that employ electronic switches, please remove the battery when transporting in a bag or at least unscrew the battery tube a turn to break electrical contact so the light doesn't turn on accidentally. This goes triply for any light above 1000 lumens because they can melt stuff. You see it on the internet, so watch out. Fun times. For the fun times, I use the included protected 3100 milliamp hour cells. The cells have a wrapper so you can see through them, sort of, and they appear to be Samsung 30Qs, which are a well-known 3000 milliamp hour high drain cell. The Thrunites are taller than the Samsung 30Qs, but that's because of the extra protection circuit built in. First is turbo. About 30 seconds in, my lux meter reads 263 since I measured 8216 lumens on turbo. Let's go with 8216 lumens at 30 seconds in. It doesn't have a hard brightness step down because the light claims to have built-in thermal regulation. About 5 minutes in, there's a 28% drop in brightness overall because it's been dropping the whole time, and the light's temperature is about 150 degrees Fahrenheit. That's pretty hot. Feel free to double-check my math, you know, if I screw it up. 10 minutes in, it's about a half of drop in brightness overall. Ambient temperature in the room where I'm at is about 70 degrees. In an hour in, we're about 40% of initial brightness. This seems to be a little too bright for what I'd expect, but again, my method ain't scientific. I'm kind of putting it in the spill, so who knows if the lumens translate accurately. And at about a 1 hour and 20 minutes in, the runtime ends with about 39% of its initial brightness. Thrunite claims 85 minutes, so that's only about 5 minutes off. Different ambient temperatures and slightly different charge levels of batteries will affect runtimes. Now high over the first 10 minutes or so is about a 10% drop in brightness. Sorry you can't read the lux meter well, I used a different lens than I normally do. Oops. It drops in brightness over the runtime, and at about 1 hour in, we have a 42% overall drop in brightness, as it's been dropping the whole time. The light cuts off at 1 hour, 22 minutes at 45% of its initial brightness. And as a side note, I'm pretty surprised that both high and turbo sustain modes this high without dropping down much further, almost to the point where I don't trust my lux meter or my testing method. And you're like, oh, you mean like the government, not trusting the government. I hear ya. On turbo and high with this flashlight, gloves might be a good idea if you're going to be using it for extended periods of time on these modes. Otherwise, you're playing hot potato. Or maybe you're just a tough guy. I don't know. Thrunite says it has an internal temperature regulator when the LED or driver temperature reaches 176 Fahrenheit or 80 degrees Celsius, it will cut power. Okay, so I decided to check out a different level. I waited till it got to the high end of the scale. After it was done blinking, I counted one Mississippi like that, and this is where I'm at. Just to demonstrate, it ran at longer times than 1 hour and 20 minutes. I guess I should have checked the lumens, but oh well, I'm not perfect. I actually had to do this twice because I forgot to record one time. A while ago, several people over at Budget Light Forum asked why I do these instead of graphs. Mainly, it helps to test the lights on the highest mode. I don't have time to sit and watch the light the whole time. and it allows me to see if there are any weird quirks over the course of the runtimes. Plus, it's burning it in for you so you know that it works. It helps you to understand that I have tested the lights and I'm not BSing you. Okay, so basically over the course of 3 hours and 45 minutes, it drops from the starting value of 107 on my lux meter to a ending value of 101 on my lux meter. That's only a 5% drop. Awesome. Beam shots. Let's do the dumb scale shot you saw in my last review, where I'm doing some whatever this is. The bamboo is about 120 feet away, or 36 metres. Here are the lights I'll be comparing the TN36 2017 to. Slow down, Mark. The light most similar to this light are the Noctigon Meteor and the Olight X7. First is my 1000 lumen context XTAR light. You remember this one, right? No matter how much you paid for your Surefire, it isn't brighter than the TN36. I don't care, you know, where you got it. Unless, of course, you got it off of a government helicopter, then it may actually be more than 8,000 lumens. Got that cool white tint. The TN36 is a bright light and very comparable to the Olight X7 I reviewed last year. The UI on the Thrunite is better because it gives you more choice and the brightness is, and it isn't more complicated. The Olight is a bit brighter and throwier, as you can see when I remind you by going back to the TN36. And before I forget, my eyes or my camera detected no visible PWM on any mode on this light. Okay, you think that's bright? Let's go to the Acebeam X45, which is almost twice as bright as the Thrunite. This is the brightest light available until... was the brightest light available until Acebeam dropped the 25,000 lumen X80. I prefer neutral tints, but you knew that. You don't have to, but if you don't, there is definitely something wrong with you. Back to the Thrunite for a few seconds. Remember when 1,000 lumen lights were bright enough? Is this a new normal? Now the Meteor. I remember when this was bright enough. I was so innocent back then. The Meteor isn't quite as bright as the Thrunite, but it's a touch throwier. As you can see, now that we're going back to the Thrunite, which is your favorite big lumen light? Sorry, which is your favorite big lumen light? I read my script wrong. Should have been a question mark there. Just make an awkward small talk. Now the throwiest light of the bunch, the TM16GT. Also a cool white tint, and it's also much bigger because of the reflector. Alrighty, let's finish up here. The Thrunite is a big, capable monster lumen flashlight. I've been doing a lot of big lumen flashlights lately, but this one is most comparable to the Meteor in X7, which I reviewed last year and the year prior, I think. I prefer the Meteor mainly because it's smaller, and it was my first. But the Thrunite, you always remember your first, right? The Thrunite has the best user interface of all three and comes with a charger. It also has many more brightness level choices without being complicated to operate, unlike the Meteor. So from a user-friendly standpoint, this one wins. What else? The fine people at Thrunite provided this flashlight for review, so a big thanks to them. Although that does not mean Thrunite, as a company, endorses any of my opinions or laughs at my joke. Sounds like I might be married to him. Ooh, probably shouldn't have said that. If you like this review, subscribe to my channel. Follow me on the Instagrams. Give the video a thumbs up. Leave a comment. And if you didn't like the video, you're a very committed hater. And that's pretty impressive. Kudos. So I've got some cool knife videos coming up and some reviews like the throwiest flashlight I've ever tested. So look for that. Thanks for watching.